this topic is vectors. Okay, physical quantity divided into two types. One is scalar and another one is vectors. So let us write the definition of scalars first.
That is distance between A and B. So if I write vector
BC direction from B to C, or if I write vector BA direction from B to A. So initial point is B, terminal point is A. So that is about representation of vectors as a directed line segment.
Same magnitude and
एट वेक्टर ए बी डिस्टेंस बिटवीन ए एंड बी 5 यूनिट्स. देन वेक्टर सी बी डिस्टेंस बिटवीन सी एंड डी आल्सो 5 and they are having same direction. So vector AB, vector CD are having same direction. So I can write vector AB which is equal to vector CD. So two or more vectors, we can write more than two vectors also we can write. So condition is only one thing, that is same magnitude, they must have same magnitude and their direction must be same. So such type of vectors are called equal vectors. And fourth type negative vectors. Okay, two or more vectors are said to be negative vectors if they are having same magnitude but direction is opposite. Same magnitude.
Then I can write vector
vector CD. Here we can see that these two vectors, vector AB is from direction from A to B, and we can see the magnitude of this vector also. Compared to this vector, if you take vector CD, which is not in the direction of vector AB, and also its magnitude is different from vector AB. So such type of vectors are called unlike vectors. So here, to compare with several vectors, so magnitude and direction need not be same. So such type of vectors are called unlike vectors. Okay, next type of vector, co-initial vectors. Okay, name suggests co-initial vectors means, so initial point of vectors are same. Initial point is same. Okay, two or more vectors are said to be co-initial vectors if they are having same initial point. For example, if I write this vector, vector AB is one vector, vector AC another vector, vector AD another vector. So you can see that here we can see three vectors. So all these three vectors are having same initial point. Terminal point is different, but initial point is same. So this is one example for co-initial vectors. So initial point of vectors same. So terminal point need not be same. Initial point of the vector same, then we call it as co-initial vectors. Okay, next type, collinear vectors. Here two or more vectors are said to be collinear vectors. So these vectors are parallel to the same line irrespective of their magnitude and direction. Parallel to same line irrespective of magnitude and direction. That means magnitude and direction is not important. For example, here, if I write the vector AB, then I can write vector AC. You can see these two vectors are collinear vectors, vector AB and vector AC collinear vectors. So your angle between vector AB and vector AC, which is equal to 0 degree, that is also one point. So here vector AB and vector AC are parallel to same line, that we can say parallel to same line. This is one thing. So this is, these two vectors are collinear vectors. Or I can write vector AB, another vector is AB only. That means AB, vector AB lying on vector AB. In that case, equal vector, it will become equal vector. That means I took two equal vectors. So vector AB lying on vector AB, that is also collinear. So equal vectors are also collinear. And one more thing, here we write, so this is vector AB and this is vector AC. So you can see vector AB in this direction, direction from A to B, then vector AC direction from A to C. Here magnitude of the vector AB, which is not same as the magnitude of the vector AC, that we can see. And direction is also not same, but vector AB and vector AC are collinear vectors. So here angle between these two vectors, you can see that angle between two vectors 180 degree. Then this is also, that means this is also collinear vector. Vector AB, vector AC are collinear vectors. So therefore we can say that two or more vectors which are parallel to same line irrespective of their magnitude, that means magnitude need not be same. That is the example here, magnitude of the vector AC and magnitude of vector AB not same. Also here, magnitude of vector AD, magnitude of vector AC not same. That is also possible here, but collinear means irrespective of magnitude and direction, so vectors parallel to the same line. So equal vectors, and this is unlike vectors, and this is like vectors. So like vectors, unlike vectors, equal vectors. So these are all comes under the category of collinear condition. Collinearity case. Now vector AB, different vector AC. So now vector AB and vector AC are non-collinear vectors because we can say that they are not in the same line. In that way also we can understand. So vector AB and vector AC are two non-collinear vectors, and in this case also vector AB and vector AC, and also these two vectors are non-collinear vectors. So that is about collinear vectors. So collinear vectors means two or more vectors are said to be collinear vectors if these vectors parallel to the same line irrespective of their magnitude and direction. Next slide. Coplanar vectors. So two or more vectors are said to be coplanar vectors if they are lying on the same plane or parallel planes. Same plane or parallel planes, then such type of vectors are called coplanar vectors. Okay, next type, free vectors. So free vectors means if we take two or more vectors, if their initial point is not specified, then such type of vectors are called free vectors. That means here, for example, vector AB, I can write the parallel displacement of vector AB, and I can bring it here. I can write vector AB, magnitude and direction same in that case. So I can change initial point. So such type of vector called as free vector. So initial point is not specified, then we can call it free vectors. So always here, that means in second PU we are dealing with free vectors only. So not localized vectors. So localized vector means initial point is restricted. Initial point is restricted. Such type of vectors are called localized vectors. So next we can see that angle between two vectors. This is vector AC. Here we can see angle between vector AB and vector AC, which is equal to 90 degree. Then vector AB and vector AC, the two vectors are called, they are orthogonal to each other, so orthogonal vectors. So if angle between two vectors equal to 90 degree, then we call it as orthogonal vectors. If angle between two vectors equal to 0 degree, for example, I can take like this, angle between two vectors equal to 0 degree, or angle between two vectors equal to 180 degree, then such vectors are called collinear vectors. Already that comes under the types of the vectors. So these type of vectors are collinear vectors, angle 0 degree or 180 degree. And if angle between two vectors equal to 90 degree, then we call it as orthogonal vectors. Then if I take two orthogonal vectors, vector AB, which is perpendicular to vector AC, here angle between them, which is equal to 90 degree. Now if I take vector AB, vector AC, then what is the angle between these two vectors here? So this is not the case. So in this way we are not measuring angle between two vectors, that is not the case. But we have to measure angle between two vectors, means we have to take this case. So this is the correct way. That means here also it is 90 degree. So here direction is not important, like clockwise, anti-clockwise, the direction is not important. So angle between two vectors means just it is the angle between two lines. So therefore here also angle 90 degree and here also angle 90 degree. It is not 270 degree. So this way we are measuring angle between two vectors. So theta is always lies between 0 to 180 degree, means first quadrant and second quadrant. Angle is restricted to first quadrant and second quadrant. So more than 180 degree means, again we can consider 0 to 180 only, it is not a directed angle. So that is the angle between two vectors.